So in this short little install.sh episode, I wanted to quickly show you how to install and use Lutris. Now I know many of you already know about and use Lutris, and I'm not going to dive into the nitty-gritty details about using it here. I'm just trying to spread the word about it because it's 2020 and people are still watching the video I did years ago about playing Windows games with Play on Linux, and in my opinion, Lutris is a far better alternative. Now it's generally pretty easy to play Windows games on Linux, depending on the distro and the game in question, of course. One way of installing and playing your favorite games on Linux is with an app called Lutris. Lutris is kinda sorta like Steam, but without a store, and with more of a focus on launching and configuring games. If you're using a Linux distro like PopOS here, you can just search for and install Lutris without any additional repos or configuration. On other distros, you may need to install third-party repo as well as some extra dependencies to ensure all of your games will run. Lutris has a website where you can find and install games, but I prefer just to search for them from Lutris itself. You can search for games like, say, Overwatch or Guild Wars 2, which I've already done specific videos on, or you can install game launchers like Battle.net or Origin and then install your games from the launcher itself, just like you would do on Windows. Some games and applications are surprisingly well behaved on Linux, like Battle.net, for example. I play a lot of Overwatch, so once I've got Battle.net installed and logged in, I just install Overwatch like normal. Another game that runs super well is Guild Wars 2. It doesn't complain about anything, you just launch the launcher from Lutris and then install it and play. Now unfortunately, as we all know, not all games work on Linux, let alone with Lutris. There are ongoing issues with games that require heavy-duty anti-cheats like EAC and BattleEye, and certain games are just buggy or won't launch at all. An unfortunate example here is Star Wars The Old Republic. I can assure you that it runs fine on my main PC, but for some reason, when I'm recording this video on the DistroDelves rig, it just refuses to launch. Another example is EA's Origin. I have another video on this channel of me installing it and playing The Sims 4, but as you can see here, it won't even show the login window. Now Lutris makes it easy to configure and tweak games with different settings or like Wine versions, but sometimes you do have to search the internet for troubleshooting steps. My golden rule is once you have a game or launcher working and running on your machine, disable any automatic updates for the launcher itself or for games or whatever, and never change anything about it. Now obviously there's like exceptions, for example Overwatch has updates all the time and you have to update those, but thankfully Overwatch is like perfect on Linux. If you've seen any of the live streams I do here on the channel, I play most of my Windows games with Lutris. In fact, all of the game footage you're seeing in this video was from me playing it through Lutris. Lutris and Wine are not perfect by any means, but they are great options considering these games were not developed with Linux in mind at all. And that's gonna wrap this one up. I hope that you enjoyed this episode of install.sh. If you wanna support me and the channel, you become a patron and enjoy exclusive posts about the channel and a playlist with old and unreleased videos. I appreciate all your support, and thanks for watching.